they have uncaged the telescope, and they're going to acquire target.
My students are 10 and 11 year olds, so some of their questions, well, first, the questions that they wanted to know was about, you know, extraterrestrial life and to what extent, you know, we were going to be gathering information about that. And while it's not the same, I don't think that this is what they had in mind when they asked this question. I think one of the things that is very interesting is tonight's mission, we're looking at star formation.
So these are just raw frames as they come off the camera.
And so it's not the type of life that they're thinking about, but it is, in a way, this idea of the origins, right, of something.
So these are now processed frames that really show the background and the actual astronomical sources. I think the science on this target is that these are stars that are really literally just at the early parts of formation. And so they're still collapsing under gravity, and they haven't fully switched on fusion in their cores yet. Or maybe it's like a balance of maybe 50% fusion, 50% gravity.
So you're saying that the one they're doing now is a little bit more graphical? It's more of a...
So I'm really interested to see some of the information that we're collecting today that deals with star formation. We deal a lot with, in eighth grade, about genetics and looking at the life cycle of genes and organisms, and this allows us to kind of talk about the life cycle of a star. It allows them to see that something even as complex or as far away as a star, you know, can have a life cycle of its own, and helps them kind of see how stars fit into that.
Like here?
Yeah.
So these are three different imagers that we have. It's hard to see because they just happen to be overlaid, but this is the target that we're looking at right there.
For me, it's been, I mean, everything from, you know, sitting down and having conversations of star formation, which is something that I've never been, you know, at a table with scientists and astronomers that, you know, can speak about that. Normally, you'll read it in books, like I said, or you'll take a class, but it doesn't get any more real than actually sitting with the people who are studying, you know, this type of material.
And that allows us to measure the thermal emission from the telescope itself.
A raw image is going to look like this, and so you can see that it's not flat.
I'd love to bring all my students on an experience like this, but I can't. So I look for opportunities for me to experience things like this and then bring back that experience to them.
And then the final step is that merge step where you add everything together, and then this is the final image that you see here.
You know, I really teach the 21st century skills, like critical thinking, collaboration, communication, and problem solving. And so just giving them, you know, real world examples of how all these skills come together is going to be so valuable to my students.
So if you were to look at the brightness versus wavelength from that image, if it were a cool object, you would see it rising.
I was very pleasantly surprised to see that a large number of the teachers that were selected were not only teachers who don't necessarily have to teach stellar astronomy to their students, but they're actually non-science teachers. And so I think there's a lot to this program that could benefit teachers or educators across the board that don't think that just because you don't teach that to your students,
to go down to that,
that there aren't experiences that can be a part of the SOFIA program that you can't be a part of.
We are level at 40,000 feet and on heading.